Hey, YouTubers, I'm in a lot of trouble. Right now I'm technically in the doghouse, and the reason I'm talking very quietly is because Mama Smurf is very, very angry with me. You'll see later on in the film, Sarge did a little puppet assault, and unfortunately, the boys in Pyro kind of put too many squib loads in the puppet, which resulted in an explosion never before heard in this region. Car alarms went off, the police showed up, the neighborhood was in front with pitchforks and, you know, torches, and the cinder block that was actually holding up the puppet was pulverized. I mean, nothing to be seen, turned back to sand. And the puppet itself disintegrated, not a trace. So small nuclear explosion equals very upset wife. So it's much later in the evening and she's asleep, and I'm gonna try to finish this update. And then, you know, that's my usual loud style. We're gonna have to be very, very quiet because she'll come out here and kill me, and we don't want that now, do we, Smurflings? Okay, so what we have to do today is to show you some of the nifty circuits Mr. X made for me for this particular model. Now, I could use several different circuits, but since I'm using his master board, which is with all the punch keys, these are the circuits that go with it and match the punch board. Also, I'm going to give you a look at saucer sections, which are now fully glassed. And I'm actually going to turn down the lights. And I did an update on the website, which is a pictorial. The reason I do the pictorials is to give some people that are building a more step-by-step of what's going on. The videos are more overviews and, you know, results and things like that. So there's a reason for both of them, in case anybody's wondering. Also, the volume of my email has gotten incredible. So I try to respond to you guys, especially the ones that I know, you know, you guys that I often speak to. I cannot answer them all anymore. So some of you that after a few days realize I haven't emailed back, don't get mad. I just can't do it that much. I'm getting 50 or 100 a day, and it's, I'm starting to set filters. And if you know, you didn't get your, if you send me in a really long email asking me like how to get in the business and 1,000 questions and all that, the filter will probably get you. So no offense intended. You know, really, the only thing I can tell you is work real hard, set up a website, show your stuff, and you know, market yourself, network yourself to that, you know, 2 or 3 guys that have been asking me about that. There's no formula, there's no secret, and do the best you can. And if you do good work, you will get gigs. It's a tough economy right now, and it's nice to have a name and be promoted by somebody with a name. But that's the way I did. I started on eBay selling them for nothing. So anyways, moving on. Okay, so now I've set up a very simple demonstration with an LED ribbon tape. Let me flip my little screen around here. And again, it'll be around the perimeter here. Also, there will have to be some strips going here and there, aiming up and down, because obviously there's the bridge and all this other stuff. This is just a simple method of lining up the windows on the edge. And God bless the LED ribbon tape for not having to have every one of these LEDs resisted. I don't actually need them all. I could be able to use just strips where the lights are. However, the light does tend to bounce around, reflect, and light up little areas and things, for instance, that are up above. Let me show you the VIP lounge for instance. Be very, very quiet. Okay. And notice the VIP lounge and all that is cut. That is the only thing that didn't get glass. Why? Because I'm using real glass on it. Okay, so now I put the top section on and I'm going to lower the lights to give you an idea of the good clarity of it. Like I said before, I ran out of media space there, so I have to do a little deleting. The VIP windows will be glass. How we're going to do this is, let's see, 4 little facets cut by the same fellow who cut the glass for the last Polar Lights Arboretum. It would have been quite difficult to cut semi-curved piece of glass for the VIP lounge on that kit. It's very tiny, and the curvature is significant in the sense it would have to be a carved crystal, and he doesn't do that kind of work. However, he can cut these four little facets, and I will get a bit of that curvature, and Elliot Brown, my good friend, is making a brass frame for it, so it should look really good when I'm done. So now I'm going to lower the lights. Again, this is just a mock-up, kids. Nothing's glued. There's light leaks all over the place, but I'm going to try to give you an idea there of what it's looking like, really just to show you the clarity of the Langdental stuff. Okay. There you go. Now, the square over here, the Rec Lounge, I believe, windows are particularly indicative of what I'm talking about. Look at that. I mean, if that doesn't look like glass, I really don't know what does. Beautiful, beautiful looking windows. There's your little bit off here, kids, but yeah, the thrusters will be there. They're all filled in except for the top, which I will do after I get some pieces together here. There's some standard windows. Also notice the light is shining through up top. There aren't actually no lights installed on the top section yet. We can see where the windows have been put in. I'm sure the VIP lounge is going to be quite impressive. So anyways, that gives you an idea of where we're at. Right now there's no primer, no light block inside, and all that'll be next. Now what I am going to do, of course, is mask each window inside and outside, and as I was saying, build up the layers and build a little ledge around it as I'm painting the model. Those masks will come off last, just like they did with the E. And I'm going to work with some Aztec dummy masks because I did not get any orbital dry dot masks yet. Although I imagine sometime during the build I may. I like to use a combination of both for certain things. All right, let's move on and show you a couple of gizmos. All right, kids, remaining quiet. Be very, very quiet. I'm going to show you two of the circuits that Mr. X sent me. First one. Now, this is a sequencer, which will have, just like I did the Polar Lights landing bay. You remember the shuttles where the lights were streaming down? This is the same thing. It can handle, I guess, a slightly more bright light. But let me give you an idea, Let's put it about where you can see it. God bless the reversible screen. Whoever thought of that was brilliant. And there you go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, if you install it correctly, you can get two strands of fiber optics per light and have that puppy streaming down the runway. Beautiful effect. First guy I saw doing it correctly was my good friend Jack Brunner from Fuzznoggin, who started building models again, I'm very happy to say. He had some jobs in there, and he was doing plane simulations and all that because he's an ex-pilot. But now he's moved down to Florida, and it looks like he's taking it easy and get back into modeling, and I welcome him warmly back to the hobby. So now, let's do this in the dark. You might like this. Ooh, the pretty, pretty lights. Notice the rotation. Ooh, winky blinkies. All right, so that's that puppy. And this is called a low-tech switch. Now, I've never actually added this effect because I always really like the blue effect of the deflector dish. But I've seen guys do that, you know, different phase on the deflector dish where you get that amber and it climbs to blue. And that's very, very pretty. So I thought I'd add it this time. So I had Mr. X make me this little circuit. And I believe, yeah, there's your in between color. That's actually second phase. First phase is the amber. Notice the nice shift to blue and then back down again. It will go through the full phase because this is actually a standalone, but the one that's going to be used in the boards is part of what's called the master board, and the master board controls everything. So on the master board, these two, what I would basically call activation wires, are soldered to the master board, and when the ship goes from standby to warp is when you see the deflector dish go through its phase, which is exactly the way it did it in the film. Very, very clever. Mr. X is very smart. Does a whole lot of freelance work for places like NASA and Boeing and all that. Brilliant guy. And I'm lucky enough to have him as a friend. I also respect the fact that he doesn't want his privacy invaded, and nor does Madame X, who also remains to be wished unnamed. And that goes with my clients too. Nobody gets named. So anyways, we're now going to move on to the funny clip of the day, which turned out not to be so funny for some people. Even I am shocked how loud this thing was. What I suggest you do is, because now you've probably all turned up your stereos or your speakers or whatever to hear what I was saying, I strongly recommend you turn down the volume for the funny bit. So as this is Papa Smurf hiding out in the studio, and if I should disappear or anything, you guys got a vague concept of what happened. Moving on.
Hello, boys and girls. Yeah, I know you haven't heard from old Sarge in a while. That's because Sarge's been on a very important mission. I want you to check out some of these files I've gathered. And yeah, I know there's some dude flying out of space. You're all interested, but old Sarge's still around, protecting your freedom. So check this out. Notice, Papa Smurf, red, white, and blue. Good puppet, good puppet. Yeah, these are mugshots. He got a little trouble, a little too much berry wine, but he's a good fella. Now check out this mugshot. Elmo, all red, commie red. He got busted for agitating and handing out pamphlets on all kinds of anarchy stuff. Bad puppet, bad puppet. You know what I say about bad puppets? Time to rid the shelf. I've been hunting him for a few days. He's around here somewhere. And when I find him, I got some pretty nice explosive tip weaponry to work with. Check it out, we're on the hunt now. Yeah, you see him over there? You're looking through my magnification rifle scope. You know what he's actually plotting, don't you? Bolshevik revolution. He's talking about Lenin. He's telling the kids to revolt. We gotta stop this. There's something definitely wrong with this boy. Look at that. Commie red. Yeah, breathe now, mother. Yeah. Alright, I'm sighting him up. That boy's gonna hurt. Damn! I believe that was a cinder block. I can't hear nothing at this point. But, I think my boy was carrying explosives, exactly as I said. Yeah, those are car alarms you're hearing. I didn't expect him to quite go that boom, but he certainly did. So about now, I'm going to have to go in the house and I'll hide. And I'm sure my wife will have a few words for me, because I'd expect old Elmo to be quite that loaded. Take care, all.
Oops. Oh dear. As a blooper reel, I didn't mean for that to be quite so loud. I put in several loads in there because I thought, you know, I mean, usually they don't go off. But of course, I never used this particular weapon before. And in actuality, the cement cinder blocks have been disintegrated. And Elmo, basically looks like a bird after a cat's eaten one, you know, nothing but puffy little feathers everywhere. And my neighbor's quite upset. And I'm sure the rest of the neighborhood is quite upset. And that was a very loud bang, and my ears are still ringing. So that'll be the last time we do Sarge blowing anything up for a while. And I'm very sorry to the whole neighborhood for what happened. Quite a colossal explosion, I would say. It probably won't even be like anywhere near accurately recorded on this camera because it was way beyond the spectrum of recordable audio. I'm just amazed that the concrete block is completely disintegrated, and I cannot find a shred of Elmo anywhere. I mean, there's not even so much as a little red. So kids, be careful with them Hollywood stunt effects, because even old Papa Smurf was quite surprised. And I'm quite sure that I may be in a little trouble. So, here comes the wife. So we'll cut here.